Once upon a time, there was a little house. And all round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left the garden very tidy because he'd cleared up and put all his things away. But there were the flower pots, as usual. Two little ones, two middle-sized ones, and two great big ones. And just behind the big flower pots was a little weed. There they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she leaned over towards one of the big flower pots and called out, "Weed! Weed!" And up came one of the little flower pot men, very slowly. He looked all round, then he went down again. Then the little weed leaned over towards the other flower pot and called out, "Weed! Weed!" And up came the other little flower pot man, very slowly. He looked all round. Then he went down again. The little weed called again. But the little flower pot men wouldn't come up because they felt rather grumpy. Sometimes people are rather grumpy in the morning, aren't they?
Weed! Weed!
And at last, up came the two flower pot men very slowly and grumpily. They said hello to each other.
Hello, Pip.
Hello, Pip.
Then they said hello to the little weed.
Hot top, keep up, weep.
Weed.
Then they sat on the edge of their flower pots and began to grumble. Then they got out of their flower pots and looked round for something to play with. But they couldn't find anything at all.
No, not teacup.
No.
No watering can.
No.
No vegetables.
No bubble bubble.
No.
No spades or wheelbarrows.
No splood or woodle woodle.
No woodle woodle.
Nothing at all. They walked about kicking the ground and muttering. Nothing to play with, nothing at all.
Nothing to plow up, nothing at top.
Bottle, nothing to plow up, nothing at top.
Bottle,
nothing to plow up, nothing at top.
Bottle,
nothing to plow up, nothing at top.
Bottle.
Then one of the flower pot men got up and wandered into the shed, while the other one went on grumbling. Suddenly, the first flower pot man came rushing out of the shed, calling out to his friend to come and see what he'd found.
Cuddles, he'll lie flop.
But the other one was sure he hadn't found anything.
No, Lobber Flobber Tick.
Oh, your pop hop.
Oh, no, Lobber.
Oh, your pop hop.
Well, he said, I can't see anything. Then Ben told his friend that at the back of the shed was a little hole almost as big as the hen hole. If they could crawl through the hole, they could get into a beautiful wood where there would be plenty of things to play with.
Oh, puddle a tick or flop up.
They went into the shed so they could crawl through the hole. And when they came out the other side, they came to a place they'd never seen before. And they found themselves in a beautiful wood. Were in the roots of some very big trees.
Oh, no, bleep trip.
Bleep trip.
Oh, rup, oh, bleep rup.
Bleep rup.
And they began to laugh because they were so happy to be in the wood. They ran about looking at everything and playing on the big roots. Then they began to sing. Trees to play in, leaves to play with, and roots to play on. All of a sudden, one of them bumped into a stick poking up from the ground. And a sticky sort of voice said,
"Oh, please look where you're going."
It was a stick man. The little flower pot men were most surprised. And they said they didn't see him. And they didn't know sticks could talk.
Oh, a little deep-up.
Oh, a little mop, hiccup, pop, more.
Then they saw that the stick didn't like being called a stick.
Stick indeed.
And one of them said, "Perhaps he's not a stick at all. He looks like a little man."
Oh, lolly pop mop.
Me pop mop.
And then the little man told them what he was.
"I am part of the root of this beautiful tree. That is why I'm rather stiff. And who are you, I should like to know? For I've never seen anything like you in all my life."
Then they told him they were flower pot men, and they lived in flower pots.
Oh, edlip, flop-a-pop-pop.
Edlip, flop-a-pop.
And they told him their names.
Edlip-bip.
Edlip-bip.
And the stick said,
"Dear, dear me, and what may a flower pot be?"
Edlip, flop-a-pop.
Oh, waddle, noddle.
But neither Bill nor Ben knew how to tell him what a flower pot looked like.
Soddle, waddle, bleep, lop, deep.
Soddle, waddle, top, lop, deep.
But the little man couldn't understand what they meant, because he'd never seen a flower pot. And he said,
never mind.
And although Bill and Ben pointed to themselves, he still said,
it's no good. I don't know what you mean, but I think you're very nice, whatever you are.
Dip.
Dip.
Then Bill and Ben asked him if he had a name, and he told them he had.
Hippenup.
Yes, I have. My name is Nubbly.
And the flower pot men began to laugh.
Oh, Nubbly.
Oh, Nubbly.
And soon they were dancing and singing, Nubbly, Nubbly is his name, from this great big tree he came. When they were tired of dancing, Nubbly said,
I shall have to go back to my place in the roots of the big tree. Goodbye for now. Come again another day.
Bob.
Bill and Ben were so excited because they'd found a new place to play in and a new friend to play with.
Nip-flip, deploy-wipe.
Oh, Nip-flip.
And they thought they must go back at once and tell Little Weed all about it.
Lep, tap, yip, hop, weeb.
Lep.
So they went back past the big roots and past the big tree. And when they came to the hole, they scrambled through. All this time, the little weed had been waiting, and she knew everything. She knew which of the flower pot men had found the stick man. Now listen, because Little Weed is going to ask a question.
Was it Bill or was it Ben? Bumped into the stick man then. Which of those two flower pot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Was it Bill? Oh, was it Ben? It was Ben! It was Ben!
Oh, what a little weedle! Oh, dear,
dear. Out came Bill, and they both began to talk to the little weed. But they were both talking so fast, Little Weed couldn't hear what they said. So she made them go slowly. And they told her that they'd gone into the shed.
We were little shep.
And crawled through the hole.
Oh, scrawled through the hoop.
And played in the wood.
Hip-a-hoop.
And found a new friend.
Dear Fuddle Nuddle Flip.
And his name was Nubbly.
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 And they began dancing and singing all over again. Nubbly, Nubbly was his name from that great big tree he came. They would have gone on dancing, but Little Weed called out, because the man who worked in the garden had finished his dinner and was coming down the garden path. So they jumped into their flower pots and said goodbye to each other.
Bob.
Then they said goodbye to the little weed.
Bob, dip-hop, weed, weed.
Bob, dip-hop, weed.
The little weed stayed behind the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they were in the warm sunshine. But the man who worked in the garden didn't know that anything had happened at all. Nobody knew about the flower pot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Bill and Ben.
There was a little house. And all round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left behind some straw that he'd been using that morning. And there were the same old flower pots. Two middle-sized ones, two little ones, and two great big ones. And just behind the big flower pots was a little weed. And there they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she knocked gently on one of the big flower pots and said,
"Weed! Weed!"
And up popped the first flower pot man. He only had time to say, "Hello, little weed."
"Hello, little weed."
Before a sunbeam shone right in his eyes, and he shut them tight and popped down. The little weed laughed. Then she knocked gently on the other big flower pot. And up popped the other flower pot man. And he only had time to say, "Hello, little weed."
"Hello, little weed."
Before the sunbeam shone in his eyes, and he shut them tight and popped down. And all was quiet and drowsy in the warm sunshine. Then the little weed knocked again on both flower pots.
Weed! Weed!
And up they both popped together.
Odd little weep.
Odd little weep.
Then one of them saw the sunbeam dancing about.
Ooh.
And he said, "There's that sunbeam that got in our eyes. Let's try to catch it."
"Lop, trouble, cop up."
"Let's try to cop up."
"Cop up."
"Cop up."
"Oh, oh, oh, hold up, cop up."
"No, you hop up, cop up, cop up."
"Oh, no, you hop up, cop up, oh, oh, no."
"Oh, oh, boom."
"Oh, boom, oh, oh, no, cop, cop." "No, ooh, bubble cup."
"Bubble cup."
"Ooh, oh, hip cup."
"Oh, hip cup."
When the sunbeam had gone, the little weed called the flower pot men.
"Weed! Weed! Oh, oh, oh,
wop." "Wop, wop, beep, beep." "Ooh." "Mm-hmm."
She said they must get back into their flower pots because she had something to tell them.
"Oh, a pop up, poppy peep."
"Another sound up. Come on, come on. Oh,
oh,
oh, oh, wop it."
"Bop up, bop up. Oh, oh, oh. Mm, wop."
"Wop,
oh,
wop."
"Oh."
What she said was, "In the garden today, there's something most exciting."
"Tap, tap, tip, potty, tap, tip."
"Tap, tip, potty, tap, tip."
"Tap, tip, potty, tap, tip."
"Tap, Pip-pop-pip-pip-pip. Modi-pip-pip. Da-da-ba-da-ba-di-pip.
What they were looking at. It was a funny old scarecrow. The man who works in the garden had begun to make it in the morning because the birds, and especially the crows, had been eating up all his seeds just as fast as he could plant them.
Oh, no.
The flower pot men had never seen anything like it before, so they climbed onto him to have a good look. They looked at his head with a funny face.
Floppy flop.
Floppy flop.
And his hair made of straw.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Blood of straws.
Blood of straws.
And they looked at his old coat.
Old lumper.
Old lumper.
With a stick stuck out of the sleeves for arms.
Fuddle up.
Look up.
Then they climbed up onto the arms and began to swing up and down like a seesaw.
Deep top.
Muddly little top.
Deep top.
Muddly little top.
Deep top.
Muddly little top.
Deep drop.
Muddy little drop.
Then they got off to have another look at the scarecrow. He was a very nice scarecrow, but they thought he would look much better if he had a hat.
Oh, what a bottle hop.
One of them said, perhaps if we wish very hard, the scarecrow might get a hat. Let's try wishing.
Lop, plop, weep up.
Let's drop, weep up.
Ah, weep, flop.
How up.
So he wished very hard. And he said, higgery, diggery, wiggery, wet, I wish the scarecrow had a hat.
Woggly, 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 what? Weep, a clear clop, had a hat.
And suddenly, down flew a hat right on top of the scarecrow's head.
Ooh, a hop, a hop, a hop.
Oh, a hop, a hop, a hop.
Oh, magic, magic.
Magic, magic.
And the scarecrow said,
thank you very much.
It's a tie of
arama. It's a tie of arama. Clear clop.
Clear clop.
The flower pot men were so surprised and pleased, they danced up and down singing, what do you think of that? The scarecrow's got the hat.
Waddle-tee-cop-top, the clear clop got the hop.
Waddle-tee-cop-top, the clear clop got the hop.
Boddly-boddly-boo, a waddly-waddly-boo.
A boddly-boddly-boddly-boo,
boddly-boddly-boo. Waddle-tee-cop-top, the clear clop got the hop.
Waddle-tee-cop-top.
Oh.
Then the other flowerpot man said, he hasn't got any gloves.
Oh, heap nob gob globe.
No. Weep.
So he wished very hard. And he said, peacocks and parrots and turtle doves, I wish the scarecrow had some gloves. And down flew a pair of gloves, one on each hand.
Oh, globe, globe.
Globe, globe. Magic, magic, magic.
Magic, magic, magic.
And the scarecrow said again,
thank you very much.
It's a fire barabba.
Clear clop.
Clear clop.
The flower pot men were so pleased, they started dancing up and down all over again and singing, what do you think of that? Gloves as well as a hat.
Waddle-dee-cutter, 글로바 월라하.
월로 딥커다. 글로바 월라다.
비나데디 폭티부. 아 벌리 벌리부.
월리 월리 월리부. 월리 월리부.
월로 딥커다. 글로바 월라하.
월로 딥커다. 글로바 월라하.
Then one flower pot man said to the other, "What else should he have to scare the crows away? I know. He ought to be able to make a noise." And while they were thinking, the sunbeam came and played on the scarecrow.
Oh, love it.
And that gave one of them an idea. And he hurried away, while the other one went on trying to catch the sunbeam. Now, all this time, the little weed was watching. She knew which one of the flower pot men had gone to find something for the scarecrow to make a noise. Now listen, because the little weed is going to ask a question.
Was it Bill or was it Ben? Went to look for something then. Which of those two flower pot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Well, was it Bill or was it Ben? It was Bill, it was Bill. And look what he'd brought. Some pieces of tin to tell the birds they mustn't come and eat the seeds. The other flower pot man couldn't think that a few pieces of tin would scare the birds away, and he said, "That's not a very good idea." So Bill said, "When the wind blows through the strips of tin, it makes a pretty tinkling noise. Come on, you blow."
Come up, up,
oh. Oh, over up.
Then Bill thought that if the sunbeam could shine on them, they would flash and sparkle as well. So he called out, "Sunbeam, where are you?"
"Flappy, oh, Bubble."
And the sunbeam came back.
"Oh, Hurrapop."
And shone on the pieces of tin.
"Oh, oh, tink, tink.
Tink, 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 tink.
Tinkly, 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 tink, 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 tink. Tinkly, tinkly, tink.
Tink, 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 tink.
They were just going to hang the bits of tin on the scarecrow when they heard the little weed calling to say the man had finished his dinner and was coming down the garden path.
Oh, cop up, hurry up.
They hadn't time to hang up the bits of tin, and they couldn't do anything about the hat and gloves.
What about your hop? Not hop, hurry up, cop up.
So they hurried back to get into their flower pots again. Then they said goodbye to each other.
Bob-up.
And then they said goodbye to the little weed.
Bob-up, hip-hop, weep, weep.
Bob-up, hip-hop, weep.
And the little weed stayed in between the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they all were, lying quietly in the sunshine. When the man came back, he must have wondered how the hat and the gloves and the bits of tin got there. I expect he thought it was the boys next door who'd done it. Nobody knew about the flower pot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men, flower pot men, flower pot men, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men.
Once upon a time, there was a little house. All round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left behind his scarf and two handkerchiefs pegged on a line to dry. And there were the flower pots as usual. Two little ones. Two middle-sized ones. Oh yes, and an old hat lying on the ground. And there were the two great big flower pots. And just behind was a little weed. And there they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she knocked gently on one of the big flower pots.
Weed!
And out of the flower pot came a little flower pot man. Then the little weed knocked gently on the other flower pot.
Weed!
And out came the other flower pot man. They leaned over the edge of their flower pots and said hello to each other.
Hello, Bip.
Hello, Bip.
Then they said hello to the little weed.
Hello,
Bip, Bip. Hello, Bip, Bip.
And they jumped out of their flower pots.
Oh.
Oh.
Then they looked round for something to play with.
Oh.
Oh. Hmm.
There wasn't anything but the old hat the man had left in the garden.
Oh, on top.
Mm, on top.
And they wondered what they could do with it.
Oh, what a colour, Doodlip.
On top, Mop.
Then suddenly, one of them said, in his flower pot way of talking, I know, let's fill it with water.
Oh, Nop. Lord, Philip, we fill it.
The other one thought it was a very good idea, because then they could have a bath.
Ah, oh, not a cuddle hop, a splupperbush.
Mm, a splupperbush.
But first, one of them would have to fetch some water.
Oh, flip, the flip.
All up. Mm-hmm.
So the first flower pot man hurried off to get some water, and the other one went on playing with the hat. First he looked inside to see if there was enough room to get in. Then he looked to see if there were any holes in the hat for the water to run out. But there weren't any holes, and he was getting tired of waiting. So he called out to his friend to hurry up.
Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up.
Hurry up, hurry up, up.
And in came the first flower pot man with a big can of water, all ready to fill up the bath.
Oh, oh, swoosh.
Oh, blip, 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 blip.
Swoosh.
Oh, blip.
Oh, swoosh.
Oh, blip, 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 blip.
Swoosh, swoosh, swoosh. Swoosh.
While he was putting the water in, the second flower pot man kept talking to his friend and telling him he'd always wanted to have a bath.
Splububush, oh plush.
When there was enough water, the second flower pot man said, in his flower pot way of talking, "Now I can have a bath, but I don't want to get my boots wet."
Another cup, Hobbush, Blubberbush, but I don't want to go to feel well.
No, mother got to feel well.
The first flower pot man wanted to have a bath too, but he said, "You get in first while I put the can away."
Old Clippip, I'll put a clubber up.
Now everything was ready. And the flower pot man got in very carefully. There he was, sitting in the bath with his feet sticking out. Then he thought he ought to have more water. And while his friend was fetching more water, he started singing in his bath.
Splishy washy wish, splashy wishy wish, splashy wash wash pip. Rub a dub dub, rub a lub lub, splishy wash wash pip. Splashy wash wash, splashy wash wash, splashy wash wash wash. Splishy wish wish, splashy wish wish, rub a dub dub pip.
Soon the first flower pot man came back with a can and began pouring the water into the bath.
Splosh.
And the second flower pot man called out, "Mind my boots." He was very proud of his boots, and he didn't want to get them wet. Then he went on singing while his friend put the can away. When the first flower pot man came back, he wanted to get in. It was his turn now.
Oh, club up. You're my top.
The second flower pot man didn't want to get out. He pretended he hadn't finished washing.
Oh, yup, yup, hop.
Oh, not a hop up.
Oh, yup, yup, hop.
Oh, not a hop up.
The other one told him he wasn't going to wait any longer. He must come out.
The one went a little. Club up.
While they were arguing, they tipped the hat over, spilt the water, and they both got very wet. And look, his boots were wet. The other flower pot man's boots were wet too. How were they to get dry? Then the first flower pot man had an idea, and he pointed to the washing that was drying on the line.
Oh, what a lot of life.
What a life.
And they started tugging at the handkerchiefs. And when they got them down, they began to dry their boots. But their boots were still wet, so they tried to think of something else. And one of them called out, "I know. Let's dry on the line, like the washing."
Oh, I'm up. I'd lie, blah, blah, blah.
So they went over to the scarf hanging up to dry on the line, and they jumped in. And while they were swinging their legs to dry, they started singing all over again.
Splush, 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 splush.
Rub-a-lub-a-lub, rub-a-lub-a-lub, rub-a-lub-lub, flip.
Rub-a-lub-lub,
splush, splush,
splush,
splush, splush,
flip. Rub-a-lub-lub, splush, splush, rub-a-lub-lub, flip.
After a while, one of them slipped off and crept away. And what do you think he did? He'd undone the end of the clothesline. All this time, the little weed had been watching, and she knew which of the flowerpot men had untied the clothesline. Now listen, because the little weed is going to ask a question.
Was it Bill or was it Ben made his friend fall down just then? Which of those two flowerpot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Do you know? You listen again.
Was it Bill or was it Ben made his friend fall down just then? Which of those two flowerpot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Was it Bill or was it Ben? It was Bill. It was Bill! Bad little Bill.
Bad pop pip.
There they both were, looking round at all the things they'd been playing with. Mm-hmm. They thought the garden looked very untidy.
Oh, idle-oddle-toddle.
Idle-oddle-toddle.
And perhaps they'd better hang up the clothesline again.
Doddle huddle up lipe.
All up.
So one of them held it up, and the other one went off to tie it up.
I flopped up.
They shook the scarf to get the mud off. Then they went over to the hat to see if it was getting dry.
Fuddle or hop.
Fuddle or hop.
It'll drop.
It'll drop.
It'll drop.
Then they both got in. And started rocking up and down.
Deep, drop, muddy little drop.
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 They would have gone on playing, but they heard little weed calling. She was telling them that the man who does the garden had finished his dinner, and she heard him coming down the garden path. So they hurried back and jumped into their flower pots again. Then they said goodbye to each other.
Bow-wop.
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 Then they said goodbye to the little weed.
Bow-wop, dip-up, weep, weep.
Bow-wop, dip-up, weep.
Weep.
The little weed stayed behind the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they were in the warm sunshine. I expect the man who worked in the garden thought the wind had blown the handkerchiefs down. Nobody knew about the flowerpot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Goodbye, Bill, goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men.
Once upon a time, there was a little house. And all round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left behind a big wooden basket full of vegetables and some flower pots. Two little ones, two middle-sized ones, and two great big ones. And just behind the big flower pots was a little weed. And there they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she knocked gently on one of the flower pots.
Weed! Weed!
And slowly, out of one of the big flower pots, came a flower pot man, first his little head with a hat on, then one little hand, with a big garden glove. And in the other hand, he had a stick. He leaned over and said, That's the flower pot way of saying, "Hello, little weed. I'm the only flower pot man awake." And the little weed laughed.
Weed, weed.
And the flower pot man thought she meant someone was coming. So he popped down into his flower pot again. Then the little weed knocked on the other flower pot.
Weed! Weed!
And slowly, out of the other big flower pot, came the other flower pot man. First his little head with a hat on. Then one hand with a big garden glove. And up came another hand with a stick in it. He leaned over and said, which was his way of saying, "Hello, little weed. I'm the only flower pot man awake." And the little weed laughed.
Weed, weed.
And the flower pot man thought she meant someone was coming. So he popped down into his flower pot again. After a time, the first flower pot man said to himself, "Surely there's nobody about." And popped his head up for a minute to have a look round. Then the other flower pot man thought, "Surely there's no one about." And he popped his head up. And they went on like this for quite a long time. And all that meant, "Let's get out and play." So out they came and ran about with their great big garden boots on, made of real leather.
Oh, Glob,
or globe.
When they'd had enough dancing about, they flopped down for a rest. And then they began to look round for something to play with. One of them saw a tiny little ladybird crawling across the garden. So small that you couldn't see it. And while he was watching it, the other flowerpot man had found that big wooden basket full of vegetables. And he thought that would be a fine thing to play with.
Oh, it's bloopy bloop bloop bubble bubbles.
First, he leaned over and smelled them. And then he got into the basket and he began to poke the vegetables with his stick. First he touched the beans and they made a funny little noise like a bell. Then he thought he'd try the cauliflower. And then the onions. And he wondered what sort of big noise the big vegetable marrow would make. But when he tapped the vegetable marrow, nothing happened. And he said, I really cannot understand why the vegetable marrow doesn't say anything. It's very strange. By this time, the other flowerpot man had come over to see what his friend was doing. And of course, he wanted to do it too. But his friend was very naughty. And he thought he'd play a trick on him. And he said, you can play the vegetable marrow because it's the biggest. But he didn't tell him that it wouldn't say anything. Are you ready, he said, but don't begin until I tell you. The first flowerpot man couldn't believe his ears. He couldn't think why the marrow wouldn't play for him if it would for his friend. Then the one who could make the marrow sing said to the other, never mind, let's play both together. You play the other vegetables, and I'll play the marrow.
Bye.
Oh, lovely. Mm.
All this time, the little weed was keeping a sharp lookout to see if anyone was coming. And she'd seen all that the flower pot needed. Now, you know what their names are, don't you? Bill and Ben. You listen, because little weed is going to ask a question about them.
Was it Bill or was it Ben? Made the marrow sing just then. Which of those two flower-pot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Did you hear what the little weed said? Do you know which one it was? You listen again.
Was it Bill or was it Ben? Made the marrow sing just then. Which of those two flower-pot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Well, was it Bill or was it Ben? It was Ben. It was Ben.
Oh.
Bill and Ben wanted to go on playing, but the little weed thought she heard someone coming, so she called out to tell them that the man who worked in the garden had finished his dinner and was coming out again.
Weed!
Oh.
So the two little flower pot men thought they ought to go back into their flower pots and say goodbye to each other. But Bill suddenly remembered that he left his stick behind. So he went back to fetch it. And what do you think he saw?
Oh.
A big white squirrel sitting in the basket and eating some of the vegetables. The little flower pot man forgot all about his stick. He just stared and stared. Then he said, what are you doing?
What'll you do, Pip? What'll you do, Pip?
And the big white squirrel said,
eating, eating.
Then Bill said, do you like beans?
No, blop, blop, bleep.
Yes, I like beans.
Then Bill said, don't you like onions?
Doodle, lubble, oddle, oddle.
No.
But just then, Ben came running in to say that the little weed was getting very cross and that he must hurry up.
Oh.
But when he saw the squirrel, he forgot all about the little weed, too.
Oh.
Bill said to him, you ask the squirrel if she likes cauliflower. Then Ben said,
double up, couple flubble.
No, I like beans.
Bill and Ben wanted to stay with the squirrel, but little weed was simply shouting for them to go back.
Weed, weed,
oh.
Weed.
Oh, weed.
Oh, bow wash, squiffle-upple.
Bow wash, squiffle-upple.
Oh, Rup.
So then at last they got back to their flower pots. And then they said goodbye to each other.
Bow
wop. Bow wop.
Then they said goodbye to the little weed.
Bow wop.
The little weed stayed behind the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they all stayed in the warm sunshine. But the man who worked in the garden didn't know that anything had happened at all. Nobody knew about the flower pot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben.
a time, there was a little house. And all round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left behind his little trowel, his big watering can, a string of onions, and a whole lot of cabbages and sprouts he'd been cutting that morning. And there were the flower pots they always wear. Two middle-sized ones, two little ones, and two great big ones. And just behind the big flower pots was a little weed.
Weed! Weed!
And there they all were, lying quietly in the warm sunshine. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she knocked gently on one of the big flower pots and said,
Weed! Weed!
Then the first flower pot man knew it was time to pop up. He leaned over and said, which was the flower pot way of saying, Hello, little weed, I'm the first flower pot man to pop up. The little weed laughed.
Weed, weed.
Then she knocked gently on the big flower pot.
Weed, weed.
But there was no answer.
Oh.
The little weed knocked again. But there was still no answer, and the other little flower pot man didn't come up. Then the first flower pot man leaned over to see why his friend didn't come up, but there was nobody there.
Oh, da da ba ba ba, flapa pop pop, ba ba woo.
Then he asked the little weed if she'd seen him.
Oh, hoppa see pop, flapa pop pop.
Weed.
Oh. Did you run a bullet drop? A cut on a butt up. And what a bar he be.
He looked everywhere for the other flower pot man. He even looked in his own flower pot. He wasn't there.
No.
Then he looked in the other flower pot. He wasn't there either.
Nope. Nope, nope.
Then he looked in the hole where the hens run in and out. He wasn't there. He wasn't anywhere.
No, not the other.
Then he started calling.
Flop-a-pop-bop, wah-wah-woo.
At last he came to the big watering can, and he thought perhaps he might be there. So he stopped and called down the spout, in his flower pot way of talking. Is anybody there?
No.
Oh.
Of course, the first flower pot man knew he was there because he heard him talking.
Oh, you want the water of crop?
No.
No. Oh. Oh.
No,
no, no,
no.
Oh. Oh, the
rubber,
oh, come on, the ball. There you are.
Then they began playing about on the watering can.
Oh.
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 Oh. Oh.
Dear, one of them fell in.
Oh, 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 come up, come up. Oh, no, no, oh, come.
Oh,
ah. Oh, now don't fall on the gob.
Ah, wap.
Then the flower pot men thought they'd like to play horses. One could be the horse, and the other could be the driver.
Oh, beep up, flop, ah, beep up, wap up.
Mmm, oh, up. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, ho, ho, ho.
Chop, chop, chop. Ah! Ah! Come up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up.
Ah! Oh, 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 oh.
But they didn't get on very fast, and they wondered if they could find something that went faster. The watering can was a very nice horse to ride on, but it didn't go fast at all. It was even slower than their old friend Slowcoach the tortoise.
Oh, slug-a-da, slug-a-lug.
Slug-a-da, slug-a-lug.
So they looked about to find something else to ride on. And they saw those cabbages and sprouts that I told you about, the ones the man who works in the garden had left there when he went into the house to have his dinner. They looked at the sprouts first, but they didn't think they could ride on them because they were far too small to go fast.
No, not too small. No, not too small. No, not too small.
When the little sprouts heard what the flowerpot men said, they were very angry, and they jumped up and hurried away, just to show the flowerpot men how fast they could run. Then one of the flowerpot men said, "What about these cabbages? We could ride on them."
Oh, clubblop.
Mmm, lip rub of the clubblop. Ah, hop deep up.
Mouth, ah, hop deep up.
No, ah, hop deep up.
Mouth.
No, bop hop dee bop.
Oh, hop dop bop.
When they had decided who was to have which one, they got on their cabbages and settled themselves down. Then they began to jiggle up and down and say, gee up, in their funny flowerpot way of talking.
Oh, chup, 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 chup.
They jigged about so much that the cabbages began to bounce. First, tiny little bounces.
Ooh.
Then, bigger bounces.
Ooh.
Ooh.
And then they bounced higher and higher and higher and higher.
Ooh.
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 They were so busy bouncing up and down on their cabbages that they didn't see that the little sprouts were dancing behind them, copying all they did and doing it all just as fast and just as well. Then one of the flowerpot men bounced so high that he bounced right away. The other one went on playing. But because he wasn't looking what he was doing, he fell off. And while he was busy picking himself up, the naughty little sprouts came, and they pushed and pushed, and at last they pushed the cabbage right away. When the flowerpot man turned round to look, it wasn't there.
Oh, what my club up? It's gone.
And he wondered where it had gone.
Oh, about club up, club. Oh, more odd, Loddle.
and he wondered and wondered and wondered what had happened to the cabbage. He couldn't think where it had gone. He knew the other flowerpot man hadn't taken it because he wasn't there. He couldn't think how it had happened at all. And while he was looking for it, the little sprouts pushed the cabbage back again. Then they ran back and jumped into the basket as fast as they could. But the flowerpot man didn't know this because he wasn't looking. Now, all this time, the little weed was watching, and she had seen which one had lost his cabbage. You listen, because the little weed is going to ask a question.
Was it Bill or was it Ben? Lost his fine big cabbage then. Which of these two flowerpot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Do you know which one it was? You listen again.
Was it Bill or was it Ben? Lost his fine big cabbage then. Which of these two flowerpot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Well, was it Ben or was it Bill? It was Bill. It was Bill. And while he was still looking, his friend came back and asked what was the matter. And he told him he'd lost his cabbage. Couldn't find it anywhere.
Clop, flop, up. Clop, flop, up. Oh, lo. Slop a clop clop.
So the first flowerpot man got back onto his cabbage and they had another ride. And while they were still playing, they heard the little weed calling.
Weed! Weed!
Oh, blubble, blubble, blubble.
She was telling them to hurry, because the man who digs the garden had finished his dinner, and she heard him coming down the garden path. So they got off their cabbages and hurried back to their flower pots, so they could climb in again.
Oh, 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 oh.
Then they said goodbye to each other.
Oh, bob, bob.
Then they said goodbye to the little weed.
Oh, bawa, and a
weed.
Weed.
Bawa, and a weed. Weed.
The little weed stayed behind the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they all were in the warm sunshine. But the man who worked in the garden didn't know that anything had happened at all. Nobody knew about the flowerpot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flowerpot men. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben.